Hey there, Gretel here from Comet Customer Success, and in this video, we will learn how to backup and restore Hyper-V VMs with Comet. We'll start with an overview of how Comet backs up Hyper-V, what the underlying technology is, and learn if there are any requirements. Next, we'll set up Hyper-V as a protected item on Comet and perform a backup. And last, we'll show you how to restore Hyper-V backups as virtual hard disk files, as well as individual files and folders. All right, let's get started. You can backup Hyper-V VMs as protected items on Comet, but just remember that this backup type is only available when running on a Windows server, and this protected item will incur a booster charge. Backing up a Hyper-V virtual machine with Comet includes, but is not limited to, its configuration file, all attached virtual drives, the contents of memory if the machine was running, and the full tree of saved checkpoints. To summarize how it works, Comet uses the Hyper-V VSS writer to take a snapshot of the VM's data on the host system. This snapshot captures the virtual hard disks and other configuration data for the VM. The backups are encrypted on transit to the storage location. You can configure local storage and pretty much any S3 compatible cloud storage with Comet. Data remains encrypted as it rests in the storage location. Customers have the option to restore either virtual machines or individual files and folders. The individual file restore browses the Hyper-V host file system, and the VHDX files appear as directories. We will demo both restore types later, but in the meantime, let's set up a Hyper-V protected item and run a backup. So in this video, we are adding Hyper-V on the client, but if you're new to Comet, just take note that you can also do this on the server in the Protected Items tab, as shown here. Also, there are various ways to set up Hyper-V, so please have a look at our Hyper-V documentation for guidance on how to set up your use case, as we will only cover a basic setup and backup in this video. Now, back to the demo. Click on Add Protected Item and choose Hyper-V from the list. Then click on Next. Here, click on the plus sign to add the VMs to backup. Choose the VM and click on OK. Then click on Next. Then follow the prompt to add command lines, set up backup schedules, and retention. We won't cover these in detail in this demo, but please check out the links below to related videos and process guides where retention and setting up backup schedules are discussed in detail. I'll keep Run Backup Now ticked and click on Finish. Set the storage location for this backup here and click on Backup. And the backup was successful. Next, let's try restoring a VM as well as an individual file from our Hyper-V backup. Click on the Restore tab and choose the storage you are restoring from, then click on Next. Select the protected item to restore, then click on Next. Here, choose between restoring a virtual hard disk file or an individual file or folder. We'll try out both restore methods, starting with restoring a virtual hard disk file. Select the item to restore here. Then choose the location to restore to and click on Restore. Great, that was successful as well. Now let's do an individual file restore. Let's go to the Restore tab again and follow the prompts as we did earlier. Here, click on the second option, which is to restore files and folders. As we've mentioned earlier, the individual file restore browses the Hyper-V host file system, and the VHDX files appear as directories. Here, select the file or folder you'd like to restore, then click on Next. Point to the location where you'd like to place your file, and click on Restore. And we're done. That's how you set up a Hyper-V backup and restore virtual hard disks and individual files and folders with Comet. Thank you for watching. You'll find links below to related video tutorials and process guides. See you in the next video.